So, I wanted to speak to this topic, and I know, like, this is okay. Trying to gather my thoughts. So, there's another reason why I've felt like this struggle to create content because there's this part of me that always feels like, oh, but you need to talk about systems and you need to talk about business and you need to be in this niche that you've set for yourself. And that's all well and good. And there's so much I can talk about on that topic. And there's so much I know that I can share. But sometimes I feel we can actually get a lot more value from hearing people's stories and hearing people's journeys and seeing the nuances and seeing how maybe our journeys and our stories aren't that dissimilar, and like maybe there's crossover. And so, something I've been journeying a lot this year in particular has been this feeling like I couldn't really be myself. And based on a series of events, I wound up back in my family home for a few months. I was back in a city I don't love being in. I was feeling really disconnected and lonely and cut off. And so I kind of buried myself in business because it was like, well, what else am I gonna do? This is something I love. And instead of doing my business from a place of overflow and giving and nurturing and like I'm here because I love it, which is what I'm doing now. Like I'm literally in Italy. I could be out exploring, and instead I'm in this house recording content because I'm so inspired and I want to share and I want to show up. And I literally booked this house so I could do that. But rewind back to where I was a few months ago, like that's not the state I was in. I was in this state of force and this state of lack and scarcity. And like, oh my God, how have I gotten myself into this position? And what am I going to do to get myself out of it? And so the reason I want to like do a few of these just me sharing my story kind of videos is because I know that in business we go through ups and downs. It is never going to just be like this straight perfect journey. No matter how many people say they got success overnight, like I don't buy it. There is a journey that we all go on. And I believe the power is in our journey, and the real wins and the real success comes from the resilience and our ability to continue to show up for ourselves, even in those moments when we feel like failures and we feel like everything is falling apart. And what I've really come to discover, and what I really truly believe is the key to success in business, is not about our educational value content, which is really important. Like, if we can get people results through sharing our insights and sharing our methods and sharing what we know, obviously they're going to want to work with us. But also, people need to know us, they need to get to trust us, and they need to form some kind of connection to us. And so, in sharing where I've been in recent months, I'm hoping that you feel a resonance and you feel like a little bit of a connection. And I've been having some really beautiful conversations with people recently where we've kind of opened up this conversation, and I've shared stories about like where I've been and what I've been doing, and like further back in the track where it was like all the ups and downs of my business journey and how I've felt very behind, like all of that stuff. And we're all just on our own journey, and that's the realization I've come to. But one of the key things that I really feel is what sets us apart in business and is what's most important in business is to show ourselves, to be ourselves, and to put ourselves on the line and to just be real with our audience. And that's really what sets apart and is what attracts people to you. It's not only the value content, it's the content that shows who you are and that shares who you are. And so, As much as I've been doing this and sharing my journey recently, once I got to Italy the other day, I realized, like, oh my God, I really haven't felt like myself for a long time. Like, I've definitely been connected to elements of myself and I kind of amplified some parts over others, but the true depth of who I am has not been online in recent months. And that's due to where I was living and who I was around. And whilst I don't believe we should cut people out of our lives, like I love my family, I love my friends, and I also know that living with them is not an ideal situation for me to fully express and be myself. And so there's this natural thing that happens when I'm in Europe because it's the land that makes me feel alive. It's the land where I know I am from. Like, yes, I was born in Australia, but I am from Italy. My grandparents and everyone else before them is from this land. And when I come here, I feel that richness, I feel that vibrance, I feel that like pulsing through my body. And so I wanted to, and like, this is what I wrote this morning, and people were like, whoa, I feel you. And so I was like sitting on the balcony this morning. Like, I've got this really beautiful apartment, as you can see, but it's like on the sixth floor of this really nice building, and it overlooks part of Catania, and you can see Mount Etna in the distance. And so I was sitting out there with my coffee this morning, doing my journaling. Feeling the sun beam on my body. It's so hot here, by the way. And just writing, because I love to write. And this is also why, when I'm in places like this, the writer gets activated. Like, for me, if I don't get to write, if I don't get to be creative, that's like a really big part of my business for me, is to fuel the creative pursuits and to allow myself to be inspired to share what drives me and what inspires me, and to share my stories and to inspire others to who maybe can't go out and see the world, to feel the world through me and my words. And so this is what I wrote this morning. I was sitting naked on the balcony, listening to Italian music, sipping on an espresso, looking out over Sicily. And this is what came through. Oh, Sicily, my heart, my soul, my home. This place is me. No matter where I am on this incredible island, because I was also here last year in Palermo, I feel it. My bones relax, my mind eases, my heart softens, my body knows. I hear the whispers of my ancestors all around me, speaking to me, telling me it's all going to be okay. I wander down Via Santa Filomena. Nonna's here. I walk into a store called Mizzica. Nonna Nympha used to always say that. I buy a necklace from there. This one. Now I have pieces of Italy wrapped a net around my neck. There's a Piazza di Pietro. Nonno's here too. And not long before, I see a Bar de Mario. They're all here, holding me, leading me, supporting me. I feel the passion and inspiration flooding through me. Of course, I have to stay here. There's nowhere else in the world I want to be. Mount Etna in the distance, fires erupting out of me, passion exploding, heart and soul coming back to life. I could set the whole world alight with the love emanating out of me right now. I just want to be here, working and writing, dancing and singing. I don't need much else when I'm here. All that chasing, all that hustling, it falls away when I find myself where I belong. I don't care for all the fancy things. What good are they if you find yourself alone and wallowing in misery? I want love. I want passion. I want art. I want creativity. I want freedom. I want expression. I want community. I want ecstasy. I want to live, plunge myself into the depths of whatever life wants to throw at me, knowing I'm always held, always supported. As long as I listen to my heart, I'm here, I'm alive. And in sharing pieces of me, I hope to make you feel something too. If we didn't come here to feel, to connect, to love, to experience the beauty and pain of life, why are we here? No one gets to their deathbed and regrets the things they did. All they worry about is all the things they missed out on. I refuse to die that way. I vow to live so vibrantly, so all out, so honestly, so openly, so fully that a legacy lives on beyond me. So you see, now I have been writing all year. I've been writing while I've been in Perth, and I've been writing about things that were moving me, mostly what I was witnessing in the world throughout the year. Like anybody who's been witnessing what's been happening is bound to have been feeling something. But what really landed this week was that we can't allow ourselves to fall into that misery and to fall into that despair and to give up on life and give up on ourselves and give up on our passions and our dreams, because that's exactly when the system wins. And so by being here, by going to that festival the other week, I was in my joy, I was in my bliss. I've been reawakened back to life. And now I get to create, I get to share who I am with the world, and that's what ripples out and inspires other people. And I know it because that's exactly what happened when I was here last year. And there's this deep calling in me. I know I'm here to write, I know I'm here to tell stories, I know I'm here to travel and share and humanize cultures and lands and speak about stuff beyond just business. And so when I come to places like this, I feel it and people feel me, and there's so much more purpose to what I'm here for. And so that's what I just hope to inspire other people to see as well and to tap into as well. It's like, what are you really here for? What's the deeper purpose behind why you do what you do? Who are you here to speak to? How are you here to serve? What is your mission? What would you do even if it wasn't about making money? Like, what do you love so much? What just has to come through you? Because that's how I made the decision this morning to move all my plans around and to stay here, because I know, I don't know what's going to happen. I don't know what's beyond the next 2 weeks now. Like, that's all I've got planned because I cancelled everything else. But actually, since doing that, I've also planned out my whole new program that I'm launching. I've mapped out all the dates for that. It aligns with two potential events I'm going into in August and September, both still in Europe. And it has actually allowed me to fully create what I want to create, because I'm doing it based on me. I'm not doing it based on the external noise. I'm not doing it trying to like please my clients and get back to their time zone. I'm doing what does my heart want? And that's all I ever want to inspire you to do. What does your heart want? And yes, I can give you strategies. Yes, I can give you systems. I can give you processes. I can show you how to build the foundations so that you feel supported to listen to your heart, to listen to your intuition, to trust in you, because you are the one who knows what's best for you. And this is what I intend to share and to open you up to, is how do you build a business that works for you? That is what systems do. Systems are the foundation that open you up to freedom, and that is what we are here for. Thank you for being here.